The map will look familiar if you've viewed the AQI before, but you'll notice some differences. Each sampling location still has a color-coded bubble indicating the current AQI level. By default, the map opens showing the highest index score of the three parameters included in the index. A legend is included on the right side of the map. Unlike the previous version of the map, you can toggle between the three parameters included in the index by clicking on each parameter name. The size of the bubble indicates whether there are multiple monitoring locations in a general area. The other monitoring location will appear as you zoom in. Let's try this in the Portland metro area. As we zoom in, we see that there are actually 5 sites located in the greater Portland area. If you change parameters and a bubble disappears, then that monitoring location is not currently recording data for the selected parameter. If you click on a monitoring location, a graph of data from the current day starting at 1 a.m. will appear. You have the option to view the graph on the full scale of the air quality index in the upper left corner. You can also toggle to different dates or enter a specific date, view station information, export an image of the graph, and export that day's data. Let's click on Go to Station Info. Here you'll see a table of site information as well as a table of the parameters being monitored at this specific location. If you click on the Graphing tab, you can view graphs of data for each monitored parameter. As with the original graph, you can toggle between dates or enter a specific date. You can also export an image of the graph or export the data from the day you're currently viewing. If you're viewing the wind direction graph, it's important to note that the degrees indicate the direction the wind is blowing from. So if the line is at 360, then the wind is blowing from due north. One other note, a nephelometer, or NEF, measures the amount of light scattering due to particles in the air and is reported as Bscat. A higher value for Bscat equals more haze and less visibility. You might be wondering where these other parameters are coming from because they weren't listed under Air Quality Index. Let's close this window and then click the down arrow next to Air Quality Index. You'll see options for pollutant and meteorology. By selecting either one, you have the option to toggle through the parameters as we did with those included in the AQI. Because these other parameters aren't included in the AQI, the legend on the right side of the map only shows whether a monitoring location has current data. Clicking on a monitoring location brings up a graph like we just went over.